Before starting the video, do like, share and comment, and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Our today topic is about 7 tips for adding emotion to your story. So let's start. Have you ever finished reading a book and walked away feeling nothing? No attachment to the characters, no joy in their success or sadness in their failings. What if somebody's read a book and feels no emotions towards it? That's about as large a failure as most writers can imagine. So, how to avoid the pitfall? How to write emotions into your story? A difficult question, since emotion is rather a slippery word that is hard to define and even harder to teach people. But it's a question worth exploring. Ready? Okay, here we go. Ask yourself why your reader should care. Before you start trying to write an emotionally engaging story, you have to know why it's important that your reader are engaged. Well, they answer, because if they aren't engaged, they won't like my books, and then I'll never sell my stories. Is a very noble and profound response. You will want to dig a bit deeper. Why should they care? What will they take from it? Give your story a few core themes that anyone can identify with. If people can't identify with or learn from it in even small way, they won't care. People are just selfish like that. Oh, sorry. Be ready to be emotional yourself. If you aren't emotionally engaged in your story, then there is no way that your reader will be. This is something that storytellers of all forms have come to recognize. Connect to your characters and make them alive through your own thoughts and emotions. Put yourself into the story and imagine what it would feel like to be this character or that character, then write. Come up with an anchor. If you are trying to write feelings into a scene, you will need a central emotion. All actions will come out of this central emotion. If there's more than one character in the room, then you'll have more than one central emotion. Pick a world, a memory, an image, or a color that make you feel that emotion. Avoid being melodramatic. Say your character has just had a great triumph. We are supposed to feel triumphant too. But maybe you are concerned that we won't. So what should you do? Start talking about how the sun is pouring through the clouds and seem to pierce into his very heart, illuminating him and filling him with immeasurable triumphantness, bad ideas. If you feel the need to be overly enthusiastic about your emotion painting, then you should probably look back at your story and see what went wrong. Show rather than tell. As much as one hates writing rules, this one is pretty good as far as emotional writing goes. Don't tell your character is angry. Show her twitching right hand and the jutting out of her chin. Don't mention the peacefulness of sitting under that tree. Show the way it sleeps well into the breeze. Don't tell the reader about the feeling in the story, let them experience for themselves. Be concise. While you want to show your reader emotion, don't show them too much. If a detail or emotion isn't relevant to the scene or isn't elemental in you moving your reader in a specific way, then cut it out. Dialogue is key. In moments of heavy emotion, less dialogue is more. It's not likely that your characters are going to sit down in a little circle and discuss their feelings. So make sure that whatever dialogue exists matters. It doesn't have to intelligence or even make sense. Emotion rarely do. It just has to make us feel. Writing emotions into a story is a difficult work. Remember that the above are the tips to help guide you. They aren't hard and fast rules. Emotion writing is not entirely technical. Try not to overthink things. Just dive deep into your story and be ready to write hard. As always, we did love to hear your thoughts through your comments. That's all from our today video. Thank you so much for watching.